In this video, I'm going to show you how to put a virtual background in a Zoom meeting. And I will show you two methods. One is when you are using green screen and one when you are not using a green screen. Green screen is normally a cloth of green color, which you put behind you when you are in a meeting. And then your web camera will see your chair or your image, and behind you there will be a green cloth. And if you want best results, then I would recommend that you use green screen. And as you can see that I am using a virtual background. On this virtual background, my name is written, my channel name is written, and I am using an actual green cloth behind me, which I am going to show you in a minute. And the background is crystal clear. So in this video, first I am going to show you the best method, and then I am going to show you another method where you don't have access to a green cloth or a green screen and you quickly want to put a virtual background behind you. But before I start, if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. And now as you can see that I am in a Zoom meeting. And in order to change the background, you click on this camera icon. There is a small arrow. And then you click on change virtual background. And this is when you have already joined the meeting. And if you want to change this before joining a meeting, then you will reach on this screen by clicking on the setting icon when you launch the Zoom client, meeting client. And here you have few images. Normally you will see these three images by default. And I have added these three virtual background images. So what I do is I just want to show you how you can easily change once you are using a green screen behind you and how good is the quality. So let us first change to another one and let me close this. As you can see that my image is again crystal clear and my background looks perfectly part of the scene. Now let's change it once again to another one. And in this background, you will notice that the proportion is not right. My chair looks very close to the floor. So you have to take care of these things when you are designing a virtual background for you. So this is a poorly designed virtual background. So let's go back to this area and now I click on none. And when I click on none, now you will see the green cloth behind me. Now this is the actual green cloth, as you can see. And this green cloth can be of various types. Sometimes, like in my case, my green cloth has two sides. One is more shiny and one is less shiny or dull. So this is the dull side, which is behind me. The shiny side is on the opposite direction. So this is the perfect method. If you have a green screen behind you, you will get good results. Your virtual background will just look like original. And now what I will do, I will remove this green screen. And then I will show you how you can put a virtual background using a virtual camera. And now I have removed the green screen and you can see the actual background. So let's go back to the virtual background area and I'm using the none. So let us see what happens if I try to use any of these backgrounds which I was using before. So if I click on that, as you can see that only a part of this background is showing in this area and in this area where there are some green objects hanging on the wall or on the bed. So it is not perfect. So this is what happens. And sometimes when you try to use any of these default virtual backgrounds, Zoom client, this software will even not allow you to use it because it will show an error message here that your computer has not sufficient capability to show the virtual background, something like that. And now what we need to do, we have to install Snap Camera, and this is the file which you will download from Snap Camera website. And once you have installed Snap Camera, this is the icon. So I click on that. And now let me maximize this. Now I am using Snap Camera. Basically, my webcam is used by Snap Camera application, which will provide me a virtual camera. So what I mean by virtual camera is that now I can apply various filters on my image And these are some of those filters which are available, which I can apply. And then I will ask Zoom to connect to my Snap camera instead of my webcam. This is what we have to do now. The important point to note here is that Snap camera is not for professional use. Most of the time, gamers use this for some funny images when they are playing games so that their audience do not get bored. And most of these filters, if I try to apply to my image, and as you can see that this is a funny looking filter, I have attached few flowers to my head. But there are some filters available which can be used in a professional or work from home setting. They have a separate work from home tab, and there are few filters available in this area which might be of interest to you. But you have to find these before the start of the meeting so that you could be able to use them. So you can try few of them if you want. And I have shown some of these in my other video, because in that video I am also using Snap camera with Google Meet, which is another video conferencing application. So you can watch that video where I recommended few of these. But let me show you one more. If I click Office here in the search bar, and now I get this office. If I click on that, as you can see that now the background looks like an office, which is perfectly reasonable. And now my image is also looking good. I'm not using any green screen. This is the background which has been applied by virtual camera application Snap camera. And now the last thing I have to do is I have to open my Zoom meeting client, and I have to tell Zoom that instead of my webcam, you should be using Snap camera. And that is it. This background will be applied and I can attend the meeting with a virtual background in Zoom. So let's do the last step. And now I'm going back to my virtual background setting area, and I click on video. And now instead of this, I will be selecting my Snap camera, because now my webcam is used by Snap camera application and Zoom cannot find my webcam. So therefore, now I have to select this Snap camera. And now as you can see that Snap camera is providing me a fantastic virtual background of an office type environment, which is perfectly fine. And this background we are getting without using a green screen. But again, at the end of this video, I would highly recommend that you buy a cloth. It only costs few dollars and you will be able to put anything on your background very easily. And now you can see both of my applications side by side, Snap camera and Zoom meeting. So in this video, you learned how to provide a virtual background in a Zoom meeting, both when using a green screen and without using a green screen. And now you can watch this video, which will show you how to use this virtual background in Google Meet, which is another very popular video conferencing software. So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.